Let us look to the translation and the meaning of this, and then I would like to tell you a little story, inshallah. It begins, in the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Allah swears by the heaven holding the big stars, and by the promised day, and the witness day, and the witness day, meaning the day of Friday and the day of Arafat on the 9th of Dhul-Hijjah. Cursed, Allah is telling us, cursed were the people of the ditch, and this is the story I'm going to be reading to you in a minute, of fire fed with fuel. When they sat by the fire, and they witnessed what they were doing against the believers by burning them, and they had no guilt except that they were believing in Allah, the Almighty, worthy of all praise, to whom belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth. And Allah is witness over everything. Verily, those who put to trial the believing men and the believing women by torturing them and burning them, and then they don't turn in repentance to Allah, then they will have the torment of hell, and they will have the punishment of the burning fire. Verily, those who believe and do righteous good deeds, for them will be gardens underneath which rivers flow in paradise. And that is a great success. Verily, O Muhammad, Allah is speaking to Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, verily the seizure or punishment of your Lord is severe and painful. Verily, he it is who begins punishment and repeats punishment in the hereafter. And he is oft forgiving, full of love towards those who are pious and true believers in monotheism. He's the owner of the throne, the majestic. He is doer of whatever he wills to do. Allah says, has the story reached you about the hosts of Fir'aun, that means Pharaoh, and Thamud? No, the disbelievers persisted in denying the message of monotheism. And Allah encompasses them from behind, meaning that all their deeds are within His knowledge, and He will pay them back for what they do. Nay, but this is a glorious recitation, the Quran, inscribed in Al-Lah, Al-Mahfuz, means the prescribed tablet. Fi lawhim mahfuz. MashaAllah. Now we heard the Arabic, we heard the English translation. Let us now understand the meaning. And I want to explain this to you, that the Quran is preserved in the original Arabic language, as we heard it recited. The meanings, though, have to be understood according to what Muhammad, peace be upon him, said it means. He is the one chosen by Allah to be the one reciting this Quran, this recitation. So it is not up for us today to decide what it means. Otherwise, what would be the value if each person can make up their own meaning? So, with regard to this chapter or surah of the Quran, the Prophet, peace be upon him, told us an amazing story. This story was memorized and then passed on to us. It's collected in a book called Sahih Muslim, volume 4. The hadith number is 7148. And it's narrated on the authority of a companion of Muhammad's by the name of Shu'aib, radiallahu anhu. And he said, the Prophet of Allah, the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad, peace be upon him, says, now I'm going to read the story to you. Among the people before you, there was a king and a magician. When the magician became old, he said to the king, I have become an old man. Get me a boy so I can teach him how to do this magic. So the king sent a boy to him to teach him this magic. Whenever the boy would go to the magician, he used to sit along the way with a monk. A monk is a religious person from Christianity. And whenever the boy would sit there, he would listen. And he used to really enjoy these talks. So when the magician, when he would go to the magician, he would stop by this monk and sit with him. And when he visited with him, he would become late. So because he was late, when he got to the magician would beat him. So on the way back, he would stop and listen to this monk speak about God and religious things. But then, when he got home, his parents would beat him for being late. So he told the monk about this, and he said, you know, what you should do when you go to the magician, just tell him that your parents made you late, and when you go to your parents, just tell them that the magician made you late, and this, then you'll be okay. So this, the boy carried on like this for quite a period of time. But one day, as the boy was going along the main road, there was a huge creature, or beast, or monster. Some of the translations, the old ones, they said dragon. Well, there's no such thing as a dragon. But it was a monster of some kind, possibly a lion or something like this, in the way. And the people were not able to pass. They were afraid. The boy said, today I'm going to find out if the magician is better or the monk. So he picked up a stone and he said, by Almighty God, by Allah, if the deeds and actions of the monk are liked by you, better than those of this magician, then kill this creature so the people can cross the road. The boy threw the stone, it hit the beast and killed it dead, and the people were able to pass by. The boy went to the monk and told him what happened, and the monk said to him, oh my son, today you become better than me. You have achieved what I see, and you are going to be put to test. And in the case that you are put to trial, do not inform the people about me. The boy used to treat the people suffering from born blindness and leprosy and skin diseases and other diseases. And a blind person from the court of the king heard about this boy, and he came and brought a number of gifts for the boy and said, all these gifts are for you on condition you can cure me from being blind. The boy said, I do not cure anybody. It is only Almighty God, Allah, who cures the people. So if you believe in Allah, then ask Allah, and he will cure you. And the man then believed in Allah, and then Allah cured him. Later, this blind one came to the king and sat in his place where he usually sat. But the king asked, how are you able to see? And the man said, my Lord, Allah gave me my sight. The king said, do you have another Lord beside me? He said, my Lord and your Lord is the same, Almighty God, Allah. The king got hold of him and kept on tormenting him until he informed him about the boy. So they brought the boy. The king said to the boy, oh boy, has your knowledge of magic reached to the level that you can now cure people born blind, the lepers, the people with skin diseases, and so on and so? The boy replied, I don't cure anybody. It is only Allah alone who gives the cure. The king got hold of him again and kept on tormenting him until he informed him about the monk. And the monk was brought. And it was said to the monk, give up your religion and turn apostate. The monk refused to turn away from his belief in Allah. Then the king ordered to bring a saw. And they put the saw in the middle of the scalp of the man and they cut him in two and he fell in two pieces. Then they brought the blind man and said to him, give up your religion. The blind man refused. So they put the saw in the middle of his scalp and they cut him in half until he fell in two pieces. Then they brought the boy and they said to him, give up your religion, and the boy refused.